Good evening, respected. Today is our guest speaker and my dear students and other eager participants. On behalf of Ward Women's College of a department, greetings and cordially inviting you all for first day online UGC NET crash course. Today, 30th October 2021, as we proudly present on exploring the avenues to crack NET exam. A crash program to stimulate the PG students. UGC NET or the National Eligibility Test for NTA UGC NET determines the eligibility of an individual for the post of an assistant professor or junior research fellow or JRF in all the Indian colleges and universities. After clearing UGC NET exam, you will be eligible to apply for assistant professor and junior research fellow in Indian universities and colleges. Qualifying UGC NET depends on the performance of candidates in two papers in aggregate. Ideally, it takes 3 to 6 months to prepare for the UGC NET exam, depending on how many hours you have devoted to study every day. So, do not hesitate to until the 11th hour. Takes about 3 to 5 hours of regular studies to clear the UGC NET exam. Hence, why you are all gathered here today on this online UGC NET crash course for Earth Science program to become a beneficiary of today's event, one among you all, so that you can face our challenges on our career benefit in UGC NET exam and meet its needs. Since, firstly, I would like to say humble thanks to our college principal, Dr. D. Gladys, Ward Women's College, to give me this very good opportunity to conduct today's event. There is only one success, to be able to spend our life in your own way. By Christopher Morley, quotes, the very pleasure to start this auspicious occasion by healthy welcoming you all. I am so honored, privileged and delightful to welcome our today's special guest speaker, Dr. P. Arul, Associate Professor in Geography, for this enlightening and spellbinding session. And he is here to give an interactive speech on the topic, broadly exploring the avenue to crack NET exam, a crash program to stimulate the PG student. So once again, I welcome you, sir, for an interactive and impactful session. Now I am handing over to Mrs. Grace to introduce our today's guest speaker and brief his professional travel till date. Over to Grace.
Good evening, one and all. Present at this online meet for this crash course. To crack UGC NET exam, you get what you focus on. So focus on what you want. Time goes on. So whatever you're going to do, do it now. Don't wait. You're born to win, but to be a winner, you must plan to win. Prepare to win and expect to win. Success is never easy. You have to put in yourself in fire first to sense it, taste it and experience success. I, Mrs. Grace Selvarani, Research Scholar, Department of Geography, Ward Women's College, is so glad and honored to welcome Dr. P. Arul, who is indeed having 23 years of teaching experience. I'm so honored, sir. Sorry for the delay. And at the same time, I'm too privileged to introduce him among you all. Though being a small gathering, I'm too honored. He's come here to enlighten us. Thank you for your patience, sir. And sharpen us to crack the NET exam, which we are all eagerly preparing for. And Dr. P. Arul, he has 23 plus years of teaching experience altogether. His area of specialization is tourism and disaster management. He has written several books, in which 7th and 8th Samachir book is also under his wing, in which he has experience in preparing course materials and has several administrative experiences too. He has guided several pupils towards success and competitive exams. We're so honored to have you, sir. He has received 2020 Best Teacher Award from Tamil Nadu Teachers Association and Chennai Tamil Sangam, and Asan Valluvar Award for the year 2021 to his crown. Now, over to you, Dr. P. Arun, sir. Over to you.
Good afternoon to all. Am I audible?
Yes, sir, you are.
Yes, thank you. I would like to thank respected principal, head of the department, Dr. Sujata Madam, who has given nice introduction on me, research scholar, and my dear students, one and all, joining in this program. I'm Dr. Arun, working as associate professor in Government Arts College, Salem 7. Since from 1998, I have been teaching and training my students in Kumbolin College. Then up to 2014, I was there. Later, I shifted from Kumbolin to Government Arts College, Salem. Here also, I have been training. I have been encouraging the students appearing in the competitive examination, especially the national eligibility test. So it is right time. First of all, I would like to thank your principal, head of the department, and Dr. Sujata Madam. It's right time. They have organized such a wonderful event to make awareness on NET examination. Why do we need NET examination? What are the measures to be taken while you are going to prepare for the competitive examination, especially NET examination? My perception is most of the girl students are not aware on the competitive examination. Of course, some boys are, since from their school days, they are aware on the competitive examination. Most of the girls are not showing that much interest on competitive examination. But nowadays the girls also showing more interest on competitive examination. Yes, you may be aware on the NEET examination. Like the NEET examination, we also have examination in our subject. It is conducted by National Testing Agency. It is simply we are calling as NET examination. NET examination, National Eligibility Test. Why should we appear in this examination? Suppose after the completion of your postgraduate degree, if you wish to become a assistant professor in government colleges or universities, you must have cleared or passed in NET examination. It is here one of the qualification. PhD with NET is desirable in all over India. In addition, suppose if you passed in this NET examination, especially junior research fellowship, every month you can get nearly about 35,000. For 3 years, the UGC will give the scholarship to the passing students. After that, it may extend up to 5 years. So think about the scholarship. Each and every month you have to get 35,000 if you pass this examination. Yes. As a resource person, as an experienced teacher, it is my duty, while you are going to prepare for the competitive examination, what are the points you should keep in your mind? In this point of view, I have suggested some points. Point number one, know about the examination pattern. Well, before going to prepare for the for any examination, one should be thorough knowledge on the respective or concerned examination pattern. Of course, the competitive examination pattern may vary to or differ to the place to place. Yes. So you should know about the examination pattern. Later I will come to the examination pattern of this NET examination. Then second point is go through the entire syllabus. Yes, it is must, it is essential. We need the entire syllabus. Generally, the syllabus will be published in concerned websites. So you have to go to the website and download the concerned syllabus. So you should be well versed with the relevant examination syllabus. Then time allocation. How long you are going to prepare for this examination? It's my perception. As an average student in JRP, at least require 6 months to complete the given syllabus in a national testing agency website. After that allocation of time, you have to purchase the relevant books from market. Up to postgraduate level, you are spending much more money to complete each course. But when you are entering or when you are preparing for competitive examination, many of the students are not ready to spend much more money for competitive examination. So if you wish to appear this examination in full-fledged manner, you have to purchase the books, standard books from the market. So you have to compare the books with the downloaded syllabus. It will be a right track to crack the examination. It's in addition, you have to download the previous question papers from the concerned websites. All agencies, they have given the previous question papers in their concerned websites. So it is advisable to download all these previous question paper from that website. Then after that preparation only you are going to appear in mock tests. Several private agents are conducting mock tests in online. So the periodical test, how you are going to write those examination, how you can manage the time, it should be essential for the NET examination. Then after that, revision. Again and again, you should be familiar with the subject. So thorough revision is needed to appear this examination. So point number two, go through the entire syllabus. So up to PG level, you might have studied very selective topics. It will be enough to pass in your semester examination, university examination. Whereas the selective topics will not give fruitful result to the competitive examination. So you should go the entire syllabus, nook and corner, spell out the terminologies. So read the syllabus once again with careful. Analyze which sections to be easy and which are tough so that you can allocate your time accordingly in both the papers 1 and 2. Well, before going to have a discussion on NET examination pattern, it consists of two papers. First one is paper 1 and paper 2. Time allocation. As I told you earlier, at least you need 6 months to prepare for the examination. Of course, 6 months is not the standard yardstick. It may be differ from person to person according to their knowledge and their desire. Just keep in your mind. So my perception is 6 months, because already you have studied the syllabus in your UG and PG level. So in this process, you are going to recall what you have studied in your UG and PG classes. So in this perception, I advised you at least you need 6 months to prepare for this examination. So the 6 months to be divided in different categories. Psychologically, while you are a student, some subject you may like very much compared with other subject. So you have to start from the easy subject. Physically, mentally, it will support you. It will encourage you to complete the entire syllabus without any obstacle or barrier. This is my kind advice. Then allocation of time varies for different individuals. However, for reference, we have served an ideal study plan for UG student examination. You need a study plan. How you are going to prepare for the NET examination? As I told you earlier, it consists of two papers, first paper and the second paper. The first paper, the asked questions will be test your knowledge in research and teaching field. The second paper, the questions related with your subject, your concern subject. Books to refer. So well before going to prepare for this examination, you have to, as I told you earlier, you have to purchase the needed books for your preparation. Of course, some students, when you are studying in UG or PG, you might have purchased or bought some books from the market. But whereas the first paper, most of the students don't have that much material. So for preparation of first paper, you should go to the market and buy some standard books. Truman, Harigan Expert, KVS, Madan, Abgar, these are the standard books. Especially these companies have published for paper one. In addition, these mentioned books, you can also refer to post-graduation action books covering the important concept in detail. But my perception, my kind advice is to chronicle, refer, sir, some periodicals may give some knowledge on the first paper. You should go any coaching class for the preparation of first paper, then only you can face that examination with confidence. Keep in your mind. Apart from books, YouTube, many videos are available online. So you can view the YouTube's videos. It will give some ideas, some innovative ideas, whatever the points to be keep in your mind while you are going for preparation. So as I told you earlier, the government agencies and private sectors, all they have preserved some previous question paper in their respective website. So it is advisable to download these previous years question papers, and you have to test yourself. You have to make your own team and try to solve those previous question papers. Practice online mock tests. If several private agencies, they are conducting online mock tests. Of course, they may collect some meager amount of fees for this kind of examination, but no other way you should appear such a kind of mock examination it will ensure your success rate. Revision. Yes. Again and again, your studies should focus on the entire syllabus. The revision is essential, must. Then only you can familiar with the concept and other related study. So I would like to give a picture on UGC NET examination pattern. Examination name. UGC National Eligibility Test, University Grant Commission, commonly known as UGC NET examination. It's usually this type of examination is conducted by National Testing Agency. Well, before it was conducted by UGC directly. By past 2 or 3 years, this type of examination is conducted by National Testing Agency (NTA) official website. UGCnet.nta.nic.in. Post, if you pass in this examination, if you crack this examination, you can get a junior research fellow. Yes, you can pursue your higher studies in reputed institution, Anna University, other universities, central universities. You can join for a PhD by using the NET examination result. Then is there any age limit is fixed for this kind of examination? Yes, students do not complete 30 years as on 2021 to get a fellowship in UGC examination. Assistant professor, there is no upper age limit for assistant professor. Yes, UGC NET syllabus 2021. So I would like to give some basic knowledge on paper 1 and paper 2. In paper 1, what type of questions to be asked? As an aspirant, wherever you should focus your attention to cover this examination. So it's related material where you can get, where you can gather all this information. I will give one by one. UGC NET examination pattern. UGC NET examination pattern. As I told you earlier, it consists of two papers. First one is paper one. The questions will be generic in nature, intending to assess the teaching research aptitude of the candidate. It is nothing but most of the postgraduate students are studying research methodology as a paper in your curriculum. So it is enough. It is enough to the paper one. In addition, you have to prepare the market guides, reasoning, mental ability, blood relationship. All this subject knowledge is essential. And this paper preparation for paper one. Whereas the paper two, you have to prepare from your textbooks. If it is possible, you can purchase all NCERT book from 6th to 12th. The given information in these books will give basic knowledge on the subject geography. Later that, you can go through some standard textbooks. You can ask your teachers. Suppose you want to prefer climatology unit, means you can ask your teacher. They will tell what are the standard books are there. You can prepare that book. So examination, as a part of examination pattern, as I told you, the first paper consists of 50 questions. Each question carry 2 marks. I would like to make one thing very clear to you. There is no negative mark for the unit 1 and paper 1 and paper 2. So 50 into 2, 100 marks. Paper 1, you have 100 marks. paper 2, you have to answer 100 questions. Each question carry 2 marks, 200 into 2, 200 marks. Totally, you have to write the NET examination for 300 marks. Out of 300, how you are scoring, how you are getting marks, accordingly, the result will be published. There is no standard yardstick or no standard marks for the passing minimum there. Each and every year, how many students are appearing at the time, their average score on the basis, they have to fix that minimum marks. Suppose community wise, social status wise, this cutoff mark will be vary from person to person. Of course, the cutoff will be high for forward community, open competition. Following this BC, MBC, SC, ST, the passing percentage or minimum cutoff will be different from community to community. Yes. But I have no idea because the National Testing Agency keep these details very secretly. So paper one, while you are going to prefer for paper one, whatever the questions are asking from various field in the paper one, teaching aptitude, teaching. The question related with teaching aptitude, generally five questions will be asked from this area. Then research aptitude, as I told you, research methodology, of course, T-test, F-test, sampling, this type of questions will be asked in this part. So 5 into 2, 10 marks. Reading comprehension will be there, will be given. From that comprehension, the questions will be asked. You have to select the correct answer from the comprehension and reading capacity. Then communication. To test your communication skill, first 5 questions will be asked from this field, 5 into 2, 10 marks. Reasoning. Reasoning is you are testing your mental ability. Of course, a simple maths already you have studied in your school days. That kind of course, it may be median, mean, average, or sometime Venn diagram. Such questions may be asked in this area. So, it is expected 5 questions may be asked from this area, 5 into 2, 10 marks. Logical reasoning. Logically, some statements will be given. From the statement, you have to choose the correct answer. Logical reasoning. Data interpretation. How the given data to be predicted or to be analyzed by your mental ability. Really, to test your mental ability, this kind of questions will be asked in paper one. Five questions carries equal marks, 5 into 2, 10 marks. Then information and communication technology, ICT, later questions will be asked 5. Then testing your environmental awareness and related knowledge, 5 questions will be asked from this field. Whatever the laws and regulations are there, what are the facts, the World Summit, people's role, government role, NGOs, government organization, whichever involving in environmental protection and management, all these questions will be asked from this area, this part. Then finally, you have 5 questions from higher education system, governance, quality, and administration. Simple question. Of course, in school level, how can we say the social science questions may be, especially the civics related questions may be asked in this unit. points. What are the points to be keep in your mind? For each correct answer, the candidate will get 2 marks in both paper 1 and 2. As I told you, in paper 1, 50 questions will be given, 50 into 2, 100 marks, whereas the paper 2, you have to answer for 100 questions, each question carry 2 marks, 100 into 2, 200 marks. So totally you are going to write your examination for 300 marks. There is no negative marking for incorrect answer in UGC NET examination. Yes. No marks will be given for question unanswered mark for review. If you are not answering any questions, marks will not be given for the respective questions. All questions are mandate. All questions are mandate. There is no choice. You cannot skip any one question there. You should answer all the given questions. If a question is found to be incorrect, ambiguous, ambiguous is nothing but confusion, either this or that, complication during the key challenge, the candidate who have attempted the questions and chosen one of the correct answer would given the credit. If there is any dropped questions, mark will be awarded to all the candidates. After the completion of the examination, if you feel they ask the questions nature is ambiguity, is there any ambiguity or incorrect, the answer, the two answer may be exactly correct for the asking question. So like this, your grievance can be post to the respective agency by email. If it is correct, the mark will be awarded to all the candidates, those who have answered for these questions. Then UGC NET syllabus for paper 2. My dear students, are you able to follow my lecture or merely I am telling? Madam?
Yes, sir.
Yes, whether how they feel, I have no idea. If they feel comfort to speak in English, Tamil, I can speak in Tamil also, ma'am.
Dear students, are you audible? Are you happy with linguistic? Are anybody interested to any comments or want to share with our speaker? Or want to continue? If any clarification, you can have it.
Ma, feel free, ma. If you are asking to...
Yes, sir, you can continue in English, sir.
Any other students find it difficult to follow my lecture? Or why not you talk in Tamil? Means I am ready, ma. Okay.
Sir?
Fine, ma. Yes, ma.
Sir, இப்போ தமிழ் மீடியத்திலேயே படிச்சிருக்கோம்.
சரி,
இது ப்ரிப்பேர் பண்றதுக்கு கஷ்டமா இருக்குமா இல்ல தமிழ்லயே ப்ரிப்பேர் பண்ணிட்டு இது எழுதுறதுக்கு?
Yes, finally I will give some finally I will answer your question, ma. First of all, I would like to complete my presentation, then only you can ask your doubts wherever you have. Okay.
Thank you, sir.
Yes, in this first paper you have to prepare the how many units are given in first paper, mean I hope 10 units generally in the first unit syllabus. The National Testing Agency has given 10 units. From the 10 units, the questions are generally asking or generally set for the students. Unit 1, nature, objective characteristics of teaching aptitude, learner characteristics, factor of affecting teaching, methods of teaching, what are the teaching aids we are using in a classroom, different approaches in education. So the first 5 questions will be asked from the related topics. Then unit 2, meaning, characteristics and types of research aptitude, steps of research, methods of research, research design. So already you may be aware on this topic, research aptitude, research methodology, you are studying in your postgraduate classes. So it will be quite easy to follow this unit, meaning character stuff, research, steps of research, research design, what are the data sources, what are the sampling methods, how the collected data are processed, coding, decoding, and then how to write a research proposal, what are the funding agencies are there, then how to write a research paper, how to write a research proposal, what are the points to be keep while you are starting a research, all these related informations will be asked in this unit. Unit 3, a passage, yes, general awareness on reading, comprehension, socialism, social media, Indian history, environmental issues. The 5 questions will be asked from Indian history, environmental issues, social media. Of course, you need not worry about the Indian history because the basics will be asked in this examination. So you need not give much more attention on the Indian history. Basics, some years, some personalities, some environmental issues, global warming, which gas is main reason for the ozone depletion, like this. Especially the geography students are aware on this the topic. So you need not worry about the second and the third unit. Then let's go for unit 4. In this unit, nature and characteristics of communication, types of communication, barriers to effective communication, process of communication. The questions will be asked from the communication. You are testing your language because you know the teaching communication is one of the skill. Communication is whatever we are thinking, just you have to express in your own language. Not only expressing your way, it should reach the dullest students of respective classrooms. In this point of view, communication plays vital role in paper 1. Then unit 5 and 6, number series. Suppose a series will be given. So find out the median, find out the mode. Like these questions may be asked. Letter series. For example, the value will be given each and every letter. L means 4, O means 5, B means 6. So the number, the code will be given. Then you have to match the code and letters. So you have to find out the correct answer. Like these questions may be asked from this unit. Relationship and classification. Yes, a blood relationship. Some relations will be given there. From the relation, you have to find what is the exact relations of the A, B, C. Yes, such questions may be asked from this kind of unit. Understanding the structure of argument, deductive, inductive. It testing your deductive and inductive knowledge on some fact. The questions will be asked or will be designed to test your deductive inductive knowledge. Verbal analogies, word analogy, verbal classification. Some signs and symbols will be given there. If on the basis the asked questions will be answered by you. Venn diagram, as I told you, Venn diagram, analytical reasoning, Indian logic. So each and every unit will be unique in its nature. Let's come to the unit 7, UGC NET, JR of data interpretation, profit and loss, percentages, fraction, ratio and proportion. Then unit 8, you have to answer for the information and communication technology. Whatever the ICT has developed in day-to-day life, wherever we are using such kind of technology to enhance the teaching profession, meaning advantages and disadvantages of communication technology, general abbreviation and terminologies, basics of internet and email. Yes, some questions may be asked from the social media. Yes, it's caliber, what kind of information we can share, which one is safer, which one is conducted by this kind of research. All these questions may be asked from this unit. From the unit 9th, you have to answer for environmental and people relationship. What are the laws are in force? What are the pacts have been signed between the countries or the international organization? What are the burning issues? Sources of pollution, suppose CFC, fluorocarbon, which is the main reason for the depletion of ozone layer in atmosphere. Then suppose sulfur. Sulfur is mainly used in tanneries in industries. Sulfur is having our capability to damage the limestone region. That's why the Taj Mahal has been losing its brightness since from its construction. Now it is look like dull. The committee was constituted by our central government to find out the reason why the one of the 8 wonders of world Taj Mahal has been losing its brightness. Yes, the committee submitted a report to the government. The industries located in and around the Taj Mahal, the material, the chemical evaporated or discharged from the tanneries industries are the main reason to affect the brightness of the Taj Mahal. Yes, like this, some materials may be used in industries when they discharge to the rivers, lakes, seas, whatever may be. Gradually, it will accumulate in particular place and gradually it will affect the human, animals and environment. Yes, in this unit, like this, questions may be asked from the environmental related questions. Pollutants and their impact. I would like to make pollution and the pollutant. Pollution is a process. Pollution can be defined as undesirable condition in air, water, land, or some naturally created things. Pollutants inducing boring materials, it is described as pollutants. So you should be aware on the pollutants and their impact on human disease, etc. In the unit 10, UGC NET JR of Higher Education, Governance, Structure of the Higher Education. Structure, what is meant by UGC? Whatever the committee have been chaired by the central government to renovate the higher education in our country. Which committee deals what about? It's like these questions may be asked from important apex bodies. For example, NAC. What is NAC? What is the main function of NAC? And what is meant by NIRF? Like these questions may be asked to test your knowledge in higher education. Recent national and international rankings. Yes, government organization and private organizations are ranking the educational institution according to their academic performance. Of course, the students' academic activities, placement, extracurricular activities, how many seminars and conferences are conducted by respective institution. On all these aspects, the grade will be given by respective concerned organization. Is it schemes of the government? Is there any scheme to evaluate the educational institution in our India, in our nation, to testing your knowledge on this respective topic? Questions will be asked from this unit. Basics of constitution and polity, some fundamental duty, fundamental rights, then fundamental laws, knowledge, whether you are having in this field to test your political knowledge, or whether you are having required knowledge in politics. our Indian Constitution to test your knowledge. These questions will be asked from the respective part, President, Governor, how they are elected, what are their functions. All these questions will be asked from the respective unit. Then let's go for paper 2. Paper 2, University Grand Commission. As I told you earlier, the NET examination, National Eligibility Test Examination, is conducted by National Testing Agency. University Grand Commission is responsible for this kind of examination. Yes, in this unit 2, whatever the subject you have to focus, whatever the subject you have to prepare for the examination. Yes, in this list, our subject code number is 8080. In our subject, 10 units have been given. Geomorphology, climatology, oceanography, geography of environment, population and settlement geography, geography of economic activities and regional development, cultural, social and political geography, geography of thought, geographical techniques, geography of India. Of course, most of the students, of course, it may be Madras University, Bharathidasan University, Periyar University, Bharathiyar University, whatever the university may be, in UG and PG level, generally all these subjects are taught by the respective education institution. In some cases, those who are having autonomous status, they have rights to design their own syllabus to changing the environment or changing the scenario, education scenario, according to that changing, they are change their syllabus. So geomorphology, since from your UG level, you have studied geomorphology as a part of your subject, geomorphology. Later I will explain whatever you, wherever you have to focus your attention. Climatology, in UG level you have studied climatology as a paper, but PG level some institutions are taught this paper as applied climatology. Oceanography, geography of environment, population and settlement geography, geography of economic activities and regional development, cultural, social and political geography, geography of thought, geographical techniques and geography of India. All these are coming in unit 2. So in this unit 2, our madam has asked me to focus very few units, but in detail. Yes, in this perspective, I would like to give some ideas on unit 8, geographical thought. Generally, geographical thought, geographic thought is one of the unique subject in our PG course, postgraduate level only. This type of paper is taught all over the India. Most of the colleges don't have syllabus in UG level. So in this paper, whatever we are generally studying means contribution of Greek, Roman, Arab. Its contribution of Greek. Who are Greeks? What are their valuable contribution to the development of geography? Means father of geography. Suppose I am asking you, who is the father of geography, ma? Please, if you know the answer, please share me. Who is father of geography? Anyone? Is there any answer? Eric? Yes, Hecates. Hecates, a Greek personality who is described as, who is called as father of geography. But in some websites, Eratosthenes is regarded as father of geography, but it is wrong. Hecates, he belongs to Greek geographical thought. Why he is called as so? Means he was the first person who made an attempt to synthesize the collected knowledge in a systematic way. In a systematic way. A systematic way, who compiled all those geographic knowledge under the entitle of just periods. So he was the first person who made attempt, was the first person. Yeah, that's why he is called as father of geography. Who is called as father of history? Father of history. Yes. Sivaranjani, you are right. Father of history. Herodotus. He also belongs to Greek school of thought. Here I often using the terminology thought. It is nothing but knowledge. We are talking about the people, those who lived in our earth 2000 years before. So at that time, where each and every step was, each and every words was precious. That's why we are calling like this. Father of history means Herodotus. Who is called as, who was the first person drawn a map to exact scale? Ptolemy. He was the first person who drawn a map by using scale. Before that, a map was drawn by people as rough. They don't have any systematic scale. He was the first one. Eratosthenes, he is described as scientific cartographer. So each and every person has made valuable contribution to the development of geography. That's why in the geographical knowledge, in the history and the development of geography, the Greek period is described as golden age in the world history. Because not only in the subject geography, they have made valuable contribution in many fields, of course, engineering, philosophy, medicine, chemistry, physics, all these subjects, they have registered their valuable knowledge. Greek. Yes, while we are discussing about the Greek school or Greeks and their knowledge on the subject geography, means even we are discussing about the Alexander the Great. Yes, in this, while we are talking about the Alexander the Great, I would like to give you a general knowledge. Who was the first person invaded, who was the first foreign king invaded on the India, on India? Suppose the question may be asked. So, first foreign king was Alexander the Great. Why he is called as so, Alexander the Great? Well, we are talking about many personality in historical point of view. Very few kings are called as the Great. Akbar the Great, Alexander the Great, Ashoka the Great. Because the patriarchs, not only the patriotism, all these, they have sound principles in secularism. They do not divide the people on the basis of their belonging religion. They respected all the religions. People go with those, their rights to follow their own religions. So that's why the special attention is given to them. That's why they are called as Akbar the Great, Alexander the Great, Ashoka the Great. question then is under the topic Greek. We have to discuss about several mathematical jargon. What is mean by mathematical jargon? What is mean by physical jargon? Yes, in which field on those days the Greek people had sound knowledge? On those days the Greek people had sound knowledge in physical jargon. They were aware on the different kinds of landforms. They were aware on the earthquake. They were aware on the volcano. They had sound knowledge in oceans. So simply we can say that they had sound knowledge in physical jargon. Even though on those days they didn't have any sophisticated instrument what we are having in nowadays. Even they tried to measure the circumference of the earth, the distance between earth and sun, moon and the earth, shape of the earth. Then they register their knowledge in the solar system. So see, I would like to make one thing very clear to you. We are talking about 2000 years before. So at that time their own interest made them to research or investigate or explore the new knowledge to the people, following the Greek Roman people, what their contribution to the development. In this unit, while you are going for preparation, it is advisable to write the personalities and their technical terms. Sometimes, for example, while we are talking about the monsoon, the word monsoon has been derived from the Arabian language. The word monsoon has been derived from mawsim. In Arabian language, mawsim refers to that season. So this kind of points to be keep in your mind while you are preparing for the paper. 2. Arab people were traders, because the Arab, we are talking about the Iran, Iraq and Saudi Arabia. You may be aware on that existing geographical condition there. Major part of the country have been covered by desert. There is no scope for agricultural activities. So their prime economic activities was trade. So in this connection, they traveled all over the world on those days, the known world. So they widely traveled to the Asian countries. They widely traveled to the European countries. They traveled to the African countries. So they had sound knowledge on various countries, continents, and their geographical knowledge. They have registered all this knowledge in this systematic way. Arab people who prepared the world climatic atlas very fast. Yes, Arab people, we are talking about 7th AD. At the time, in Arabian culture, their religion president was head of the polity, head of the nation, Khalifa, who invited the experts from various civilizations and asked them to translate their knowledge in Arabian language. They asked the expertise in various fields, disseminate your known knowledge to other people. It's like this, the Muslim people were encouraged by the Khalifa to enhance their knowledge in various fields. So they had sound knowledge in climatology. World climatic atlas was prepared by Arabian people. Those people declared very fast about the monsoon. Monsoon is a seasonal wind. It is blowing from a particular direction to particular months. They declared to the world. They prepared a world climatic region and nature region. Following this, these people have made valuable contribution to the development of the earth. What are the important personalities are there? What are the main books written by them? What are the terminologies introduced by the Chinese scholars. Yes, yes, when we are talking about the Indian scholars, even our ancient Indian had sound knowledge in the subject. They had sound knowledge in the field of astrology. They were sound knowledge. They had sound knowledge in the solar system, evolving rotation. What are the sources are available to know about the past Indians, our ancient Indians, and their geographical knowledge means epics, lyrics, poems, Ramayana and Mahabharata. These are the two great epics. From the epics, they have registered a lot of geographical knowledge. From the epics, we can understand the ancient people and their knowledge on the subject geography. They have registered about the Bhukambas. They have registered about eclipse, grahanas, eclipse. Even ancient Indian, our ancient Indian had sound knowledge in this field. So the questions may be asked from the later topics. So keep it in mind. Then contribution of Jarfers, German school. After that, we are studying the geographical on the basis of the country wise. Country wise, German school of thought, French school of thought, American school of thought, British school of thought. Under this title, we have to study the various country people and their sound knowledge on the subject geography. So when did the geography, when did the subject geography started as a separate discipline in institution? After the 17th AD only, our subject taught in universities, colleges in all over the world. Before that, it was taught as a part of other subject. So under the title of Kant, Alexander von Humboldt, Karl Ritter, Carlson, these are the personalities belonging various school of thought. Each and every have made valuable contribution. They have introduced some technology, terminologies. They have introduced some concept. They have written some books. All this should be focused in your preparation. Keep in your mind impact of Darwinian theory on geographical thought. How the Darwin? You may be aware of that great scientist. Darwin, in this theory, who has explained that evolution of organism from one cell to a big mammal. Whatever the changes have been taken in between the various stages, all those truths have been explained in this Darwinian theory. Then after that theory, whatever the changes, whatever the influence have made on geographical thought, this contemporary tension geography, Indian geography. When did the subject geography introduced in your colleges, universities? So whichever universities are expertise in particular field, cartography, thematic, ethnological contribution, major geographic tradition, science tradition, man. In the initial stage, geography was considered by the people to study about only the topographical distribution on the Earth's surface. They didn't give much more attention on the other aspect. Especially, they didn't study the relationship between man and the environment. But in the tradition, man and environmental relationship, in this tradition only, the people started to study about the relationship between man and the environment. Because without man, the studying subject will be meaningless. Then only we have started to focus our attention on the relationship between man and the environment, area studies. So in this title, we have to study the entire world into different regions. Each and every region have its own or unique nature. Then spatial analysis, spatial wind distribution. How, when, where, what? All those questions are related with the spatial analysis. Dualism in geography studies. dualism is nothing but we have to compare two different fields and understand each and every subject in detail. Physical versus human. Physical therapy. In this part, we have to only focus on physical aspect. We do not give much more attention on human activities. Physical, for example, geomorphology, oceanography, hydrology. These are physical therapy. In this only we are studying the natural forces and how they modify the various landforms. Whereas the human therapy, how these landforms are controlled, how the population distributions are controlled, determined by the existing landforms. So regional versus systematic. Region, it includes all aspects. For example, regional geography of India, we have to study from locational geography location to up to trade and commerce. So we have to study all these aspects in this title. Systematic. In this methodology, we have to approach our subject in a systematic way. Step by step, we have to study. Qualitative and quantitative. Yes, to understand this concept, I would like to give you a simple explanation to you. Qualitative. Suppose, which is the highest mountain in the world? You can answer. All you may be aware on that. Everest is the highest peak in the world. This is the qualitative statement. Highest, for superlative degree. Whereas, when you are using quantitative knowledge in describing this fact, you have to tell the exact height. The actual height of the Everest is 8,848 meters from the sea level. Geographic and numismatic. These are the two concepts approaching the subject in a systematic way. In paradigm shift, since from its origin, how the meaning of the subject has been changing from period to period. Initially, our subject was started as an art subject. Later, it was upgraded as science subject. Nowadays, it has changed as technological related subject. Those who have completed MSc degree, you can join. You can appear in TANSET examination is conducted by Tamil Nadu government. According to the examination performance, you can get admission in Anna University. You can join in M.Tech Remote Sensing or M.T. Master of Town Planning. Such kind of studies you can join. Perspective in geography. It's the nature of geography. In this title, we have to study nature of geography, positivism, behavioralism, humanism, structuralism, feminism, and postmodernism. It's while you are preparing these topics for your competitive examination, who postulated this that concept? What is the key or what is the core of that concept? How it is? Is there any criticism given by the other people? All those facts to be keep in your mind while preparing geographical thought. The preparation of geography thought is essential because nearly about 20 marks. Yes, the 20 marks questions will be asked from this unit itself. Then political geography also closely related with the modern geographical thought. Is in this title you have to study boundaries and frontiers. Is how the international boundaries are, what is meant by natural boundaries, is there any dispute, how these are demarcated, how these are making problem among the world countries. All these issues are discussing in this topic, boundaries and the frontiers. Heartland and the rimland theories. Heartland. who postulated that heartland theory, when, which year, which country. Originally, this theory focus on what? How this theory is correlated with the world political affairs? What is rimland? What is the difference between heartland and the rimland theories? The personalities, how they differ their views on the world politicals, how they correlate their theories with the world political affairs, trends and developments in political geography, geography of federalism, political geography. Anyway, in this branch, we have to correlate the geographical factor with the political scenario, political events, how the geography plays vital role in determining all the political affairs. All these are under the, we are studying in this paper, geography of federalism. Each and every nation having its own unique constitution. Yes, whatever the methodology are followed there. What is meant by federalism? Electoral reforms in India. As one of the biggest democracies in our world. How the elections are conducted. What are the voting systems are practiced in our India. Determinants of electoral behavior. Geopolitics of climate change, geopolitics. These are the world issues. What are the nations and their role in this related aspects or related issues? What are the pacts has been signed in between the nation? Geopolitics of world resources, geopolitics of Indian Ocean. Is there any dispute between the sharing their sea boundary? Yes, generally nautical miles are used to demarcate the sea boundaries in general. Beyond that, no one can go there, another or a neighbor boundary. If they cross that national, international boundary, the dispute arises. For example, India and fishermen, Indian fishermen and Sri Lanka fishermen. Often we have faced such a kind of problems. What is the relationship between politics and this kind of events? New politics of the world, natural resources, on the basis of them, world resources, how we are classifying the world countries in different nations, how they are termed as different . Yes, in this unit 7 we have cultural, social and political geography. Concept of culture. What is meant by culture? Origin place. How many cultures are there? Which one is the oldest culture? What is meant by Western culture? Whatever the countries have its oldest civilization in the world. Cultural complexes. So no one culture in the world is unique or pure. All the culture has been mixed one. Areas and region. What is meant by region? How it is demarcated? Cultural heritage. Heritage. Cultural ecology. What are the factors that determine cultural ecology? Cultural convergence. How the different kinds of culture in under their mixing as the result, what a new culture has emerged. Social structure and processes. Social well-being and quality of life, social exclusion, spatial distribution of social groups. What are the social groups are distributed all over the world? What are their main issues? Which kind of race they are belonging? What part they are struggling? What is meant by social well-being? How the quality of life is determined? What is meant by social exclusion? Is there any practice, is there a common practice or especially practice in particular community or particular society? What kind of, how many tribal peoples are there in India? Is there any caste system practiced in our India? How many religions are there? what are their books, who started that respective religion, their main principles, how many languages are there, which one is the oldest language in our nation, environment and human health, what is the relationship between the environment and human health, diseases, ecology, how the geographical knowledge plays vital role to study the disease and the distribution, nutritional status, what kind of nutrition is needed for this kind of organs, or to lead a healthy life, whatever the nutrients are required, etiological conditions, classification and species and seasonal distribution pattern with this special reference to animal. We have to apply these concepts, this is ecology, nutritional status, environment and human in world scenario as well as Indian scenario. Healthcare planning and policies in India. What are the healthcare planning implemented by state and central government? Is there any schemes, welfare schemes are available to enhance the rural health in our India? Policies, medical policies in India. What is meant by medical tourism? Why should we develop? Why should the essential to develop such a kind of medical tourism in India? All those aspects we have studied under this topic in this unit. So in this level, I would like to wind up my lecture.
Thank you, sir, for your enthralling crafting session. You shine as a candle in the dark room, lightening us while giving us a hope during this dark time for learners like us. Once again, thank you, sir. Over to ma'am.
Thank you would be just a word for this empowering session. But more than that, my heartfelt gratitude is being registered now and is being overwhelming with a thankful heart for this event, which was too successful with flying colors. And I personally thank Dr. P. Harul, sir, for this empowering session. And I thank our chief patron, Dr. D. Gladys, Principal, Bar Women's College, for her constant support. Thank you all participants. With you, this first day UGC NET crash course have reached its purpose. Once again, thank you one and all for your active participation. Last but not least, I thank Almighty God for His influence and His abundant blessing and guidance throughout this session for this great success. Thank you all.